Hey everyone, Rodney here from Cleves Tech, and today I'm going to talk about my favorite new checkpoint model for Stable Diffusion. Cheyenne is geared towards things like comics, paintings, line art, etc., and not towards realistic photos. Although prompts geared towards photos can still give some interesting results that I didn't expect. This is an SDXL checkpoint, and since Fooocus is my primary tool for Stable Diffusion, I use that to generate the images. If not familiar with Fooocus, I do recommend checking it out for some much easier image generation when you don't want to use those more complex tools. I do have lots of videos on using Fooocus if you want to check those out. The images I generated were with the four-step lightning preset in Fooocus, which is using the four-step lightning LoRa with this checkpoint. I also generated using the 30-step and the 60-step quality settings, and honestly, there's really not much difference between both of those. They produce almost exactly the same images, so usually I find 30 steps will work fine. Now, all images generated using the same seed. Some of these I will be showing with the 30-step and others with the 60-step. I also did have the Fooocus V2 enabled for these because I do find that's one of the things that gives Fooocus great image generation. Now, I've also found that it can be very useful to adjust the guidance scale to see the different results with this. I found that in Fooocus, 4:8 works best. Now, some of the test prompts for photos, type images, I did leave in the mix just to see how they come out. Now, if you're not familiar with how to install these checkpoints, most of the UIs, what you just need to do is download them and put them in the checkpoint folder. There'll be a model folder of checkpoints. I do have a video on how to do it in Fooocus, and if you're using Fooocus on Colab, I do show how to do it on there. Although the one thing you may have to do is add the API key, which I didn't mention in the video because it's hit or miss. Some of them you have to, some you don't. With this one, you do in Colab. There's no specific lightning checkpoint for this in Fooocus. When you use the lightning setting, it enables the four-step lightning LoRa, which allows you to use any checkpoint with the lightning settings to get the four-step generation. Now, I'm not gonna be comparing these per se. I just wanted to show because I know some people don't have powerful enough systems, so they use the lightning to be able to generate quicker. So I want people to get an idea of what the results would look like on that as well. And on some of these, I will be showing the 60 or 30 step. But as I said, pretty much almost identical images. Most of them, I had a hard time telling the difference when I was looking at them. And so let's just jump into some of these. I'm gonna cycle through these pretty quick. We're not gonna sit here. If you obviously wanna pause on them, you can. I'm not gonna critique them too much unless I think they're too horrible. So let's jump into that. So we have our Viking sailing ship here. Move on to our isometric style house. And for this, definitely different results. And I actually was, the one on the right was what I was going for, more of a game asset type thing, which I didn't really get, but I didn't specify that in the prompt. So I'm not gonna blame Lightning for not getting what I wanted. It can't read minds. And we have our surreal landscape featuring floating islands. And I will say that the higher quality ones do have more vibrant colors than the Lightning ones do. And we have our watercolor painting, a cozy hobbit hole burrowed in the side of a grassy hill. And we have our anime artwork, concept art. I've done this one on a few different checkpoints, and the one on the right is usually about what I get with a lot of them. I think most of these do pretty good with this one. Now we have our character design sheet, a goblin warrior, character reference sheet. A beautiful woman relaxing under a waterfall, bikini dense jungle, rainbow, and mist of waterfall. Now usually most models will give a photograph type result from this one, but this model doesn't really give you a photograph. Now, as far as our die cut sticker goat wearing headphones on this one does pretty well. I'm not sure how the lightning normally does, so I can't really compare that. And I really don't use the lightning setting for the most part. So, but I do like with these come out with nice clear edges, much easier to remove the background. This one is more of it's a photograph prompt. Yeah, it does okay. Obviously not going to give the photograph results, but Lightning seemed to have a little bit of a hard time with this one and figuring things out. Then we have Michael Jackson singing and standing in a microphone. And this is the abstract style black and white drawing with red pops of color. I think both of them got it pretty well. And we have our portrait photo of a stormtrooper, which isn't going to necessarily be a photo, although the quality settings definitely tried to go that route. I think in this realm, it gives more of a rendered look versus the one on the left. A gorgeous woman soaking in the sun on a beach, wearing a bikini 1970. The lightning one definitely had some issues with this one, but I have to say the other one came out extremely well. And we have Darth Vader sitting on a toilet, reading a newspaper in a bathroom decorated in pink and blue baby decor. Can't say much for that lightning one, though. Darth Vader's got a portrait of himself in the bathroom. Now for our ladybug. Now this is a macro sharp focus. And this one, I was actually surprised at how well these came out. I was very pleasantly surprised with this model to get these types of results. And we have a goblin relaxing on a tropical beach, drinking a mixed drink, surrounded by beautiful women in bikinis. Always get a female goblin out of this one. Never used to. But all the models seem to want to do that now. Well, that's fine. Then we have a mystical forest scene with giant glowing mushrooms, moss-covered trees, and a whimsical fairy village. This one is an alligator emerging from water, telephoto lens. This one usually gives very good results, but since it's geared more towards photo, it's not really as good as I would hope. Although it's not bad. I like the lightning one, actually. And we have a little girl with a yellow balloon, ink painting style with a watercolor effect, black and white. Painting of a farm scene, farm animals, young woman sitting on a fence, style of Norman Rockwell. This is one of the 30-step ones. As I said, they pretty much were almost identical with all of these. A fantasy illustration of a powerful wizard casting a spell with magical runes and energy swirling around them. Well, the lightning one definitely has some extra fingers, and looks like he had an accident with that fireball there. A painting of Danny DeVito eating a rum ham. A still life of assorted fruits on a rustic wooden table with a vintage wine bottle. A woman eating a burger in a diner. Pink and blue interior, neon lights, 1975. This one, I think the lightning came out really well. I think the other one was definitely too bright of colors for what I would be wanting. Although it did do much better with the words and everything. Although I have fixes for that. Which, if you haven't seen my other video on how to create text effects or how to do text, I do recommend checking that out. A beautiful portrait photograph of a dragon with diamond and gemstone scales. Now this one, I like the lightning one a lot. I really like that lightning one. Fallout concept art, hospital interior, render grim, nostalgic lighting, Unreal Engine 5. Then we have our D&D map with roads for printing, highly detailed with many towns. And now is one of our photograph prompts that I left in there, and it comes out very well. I was very satisfied with the results on that. And this one is also another photograph one, a path in the woods with leaves and the sun shining in the autumn. I like both of these. Well, now that you've seen some of what Cheyenne can do, I would recommend downloading it and checking it out. If you found the video helpful, please do consider hitting the like button because it does help. And I also do appreciate all the viewers who have donated recently. It really helps compared to what I normally get from YouTube. Thanks for watching and have fun creating.